Supercars, the cars of our dreams. Cars that make a statement wherever they go. For most of us normal people, they're pretty unattainable. With price tags well into the six figures, we couldn't even imagine owning one. I mean, I know I can't. But why do they cost so much? They're just cars, aren't they? They have four wheels, two doors, an engine. Why does a Ferrari cost 10 times what a Camry does? And what really separates them from your average sports car? And how the heck do companies like Bugatti convince people to spend over $1 million on a car? Well, stay tuned. We're about to tell you exactly why supercars are so expensive, and then you can make up your own mind about whether or not they're worth it. You know what is worth it? Subscribing to Ideal Media. We're no supercar, but we're also not gonna cost you a thing. All right, let's get into it. First, we should all agree that supercar as a word is a pretty loose term. And it dates back even to the 60s in America. There is no defined performance metric or anything that really defines one car or another as a supercar. It's pretty subjective. So while some, like me, might consider a Nissan GTR or a Chevy Corvette a supercar because of their performance, others might argue that they're not expensive or exclusive enough to be a supercar. Whatever you consider to be a supercar probably has some pretty astounding performance. Today, the definition of a supercar pretty much starts at 500 horsepower and regularly goes even to double or triple that number. Take the McLaren 720S, for example, which sounds more like a skateboard trick than a car. Its 4-liter twin-turbo V8 is capable of producing an astonishing 710 horsepower. And, well, tell him, Kanye. No one meant to have all that power. And when people are paying six figures or even $1 million for some of these rides, they better be fast. Now, creating a car that generates that much power and is reliable, that is no small task. And it's a task that, let's be honest, a lot of supercar manufacturers don't really nail. Still, supercars are true feats of engineering, and the companies that build them are gonna make you pay big money for all that R&D that went into making them. But it's not just R&D into horsepower. That would be boring. There's also plenty of top-of-the-line and groundbreaking technology that gets its start in supercars that eventually ends up in your road car. Supercars are very often on the cutting edge of technological advancements in the automotive industry. And I'm sure you know, anytime a new technology comes out in any industry, it's usually coupled with a big-ass price tag for the first couple of years until other people start making it. So the reason that new McLaren cost over 100 grand? It has tons of new technology in it that's never been seen before, so McLaren can charge a pretty penny for it. Look at the Rimac Concept 1, for instance. This is the most powerful electric car ever built today, and that might change by the time this video goes up. There's new electric cars announced every day. It's got four 92 kilowatt motors, one for each wheel, and combined create a total of 1,088 horsepower. Electric horses though, so they're different. They're like robot horses. Electric car technology is changing constantly, and cars like the Rimac Concept 1 are the pinnacle of that technology. And since Rimac has redefined what an electric supercar can be, they think they can charge $980,000 for it. And let's be honest, somebody will probably buy one. That's the equivalent of maybe like a one-bedroom apartment here in Seattle. I think I'd rather have the Rimac. But fast forward 10 years from now, thanks to the development of companies like Rimac, electric cars are probably gonna be faster and more technologically advanced than ever before. So you see, supercars are basically like NASA for cars. Now, supercars really are a feast for the eyes. They're beautiful, they're exotic, they're curvy, they're gigantic, they always come in crazy colors. But they're also a feast for the butt. That's right, supercars are a butt feast.
But.
Oh, Charlie,
give
no.
It to me.
Let me explain. If you're gonna shell out that massive stack of cash that it costs to get into a supercar, you expect the beautiful exterior that's there to impress others. I mean, that's pretty much why you buy a supercar, is to impress other people. But the reality is you're gonna spend most of your time in the driver's seat. So you're gonna want your interior to feel more like the lobby of the Ritz-Carlton in New York and less like a sleazy, low-budget motel. So another reason for the price hike is that an incredible amount of work goes into designing the interiors and finding the materials of supercars to give those interiors the most luxurious feel possible. For example, take what Rolls-Royce goes through just to find the leather for their interiors. They go to small markets all across Italy to find the perfect leather for their luxury interiors. Eventually, they settled on a father and son operated leather producer, who now deals exclusively with Rolls-Royce, with the leather they produce coming from bulls who are grown for their meat and are not factory farmed, resulting in a soft and comfortable leather that screams luxury and is also exclusive to the Rolls-Royce brand, which, when you're buying a $400,000 $100,000 car, exclusivity is kind of the name of the game. Rolls-Royce also uses 1/6 the amount of paint that other manufacturers use, which lets the natural feeling of this high-quality leather really shine through. It's this kind of attention to the small details that sets supercars apart from your average Toyota, and is exactly the kind of thing that makes it so that a supercar is priced out of basically what 99% of the world's population can afford. And beneath all of that leather and fine material, the quality continues to excel, especially when you're talking about the ultra-fast record setters coming from brands like Bugatti. Underneath all the paint and carbon fiber, you're gonna find engineering that you will just not find in any other vehicle on the planet. With supercars out there like the Bugatti Chiron Supersport 300, just kidding, I know it's Chiron.
Ha! Gotti! Ha!
Which can hit top speeds of over 300 miles per hour and go 0 to 60 in just 2.4 seconds. The internal structure of a car like that has to withstand insane tolerances. Modern supercars need the latest and greatest in material technology to keep up with the performance that their power plants are producing. And today, carbon fiber is that material of choice for its lightweight and steel-like strength. Because if you want to hit 300 miles per hour, you need a chassis that's durable enough, but is also light enough to fly. So cars like the Ferrari LaFerrari utilize a carbon fiber reinforced polymer in their frames to allow them to hit such insane speeds, but also survive when things go wrong, which they do. And look, carbon fiber does not come cheap. For example, your average Toyota costs about $12,000 to produce, but estimates of the current Ferrari manufacturing process is upwards of $150,000 per car. So how do brands like Ferrari make money on these cars? Options. Hey, you like this shirt? Buy it. Okay, cool. Let's get on with the video. There you go. There's your shirt plug, editor. Put that in your video. Let's just talk about shirts for a second. Shirts are cool. Shirts aren't as expensive as supercars. Hey, did you know this shirt has a supercar on it? Look, it's got a little supercar right there. It's got one on the back too. This shirt has two supercars on it. This shirt is basically worth like $300,000. So you should buy it. Go buy a shirt. Please buy this shirt. Okay, what were we talking about? We were talking about options. Hello, internet. Welcome back. Now, let's be honest, if you're driving a supercar, a big part of the reason you're driving one is because you want to differentiate yourself from the average Joe. Which, average Joe gets a bad rap, man. Dude's kind of a cool dude. Why would you want to be different from him? He's actually really nice.
Hi, my name is Phil. Most of my friends call me Big Phil.
You want people to know you're rich as hell, and that you can afford to be driving a car that no one else is driving. The problem is you live in Beverly Hills, and everyone else has a McLaren. So how the hell do you differentiate yourself? You want a car that is uniquely your own. I'm riffing now, man. I'm f***ing, that cold brew is kicking. Good news, that supercar company has a ton of options for you so that you can stand out from all the other supercar owners at the Mall of Dubai. You want a paint job that no one else has and that draws tons of attention? Great, it's yours. Name your price. How much do you want to spend? The options on most modern supercars are pretty much only limited by the amount of money you have. Which, if this sounds fun to you, check out this other video I made about all the crazy options you can get in a modern supercar. So sure, if you're willing to put $500,000 in Captain Bugatti's pockets, he's gotta be a captain, right? I mean, his cars cost like over $1 million. You don't get there by being like a private. It's not private Bugatti. It's not even like Corporal Bugatti, unless Corporal's higher than Captain. I don't know anything about the military. Boy, editor, I'm going off the deep end. You do have a great deal of negotiating power when it comes to building out your supercar. And that's part of the reason these cars are so sought after. So just like Jared Leto's customized Gucci jacket, supercars are a true sign of real wealth. So having a ride that's one of a kind, even in the supercar world, lets other people know that you're stacking some serious cash. Which, why that's important to you, I don't know. But probably because I don't have any money, so it's not really important people know how broke I am. Although I keep telling you guys, so maybe that's what I'm doing. I'm letting you guys know how broke I am. It's a status symbol. And just like Jared Leto's custom Gucci jacket, these are not mass-manufactured machines. They are not coming off of an assembly line. If you're a fan of high fashion, you probably know the word couture. I'm not a fan of high fashion, so I don't know this word. Couture. Couture? Couture.
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 It's basically just a fancy way of saying handmade. It's also a fancy French way of saying expensive. This principle does not just apply to the fashion industry. A big part of the reason your Ferrari is so expensive is because it's a handcrafted work of high performance machinery. And since these rides aren't built on an assembly line and ready to order, owners typically have to wait weeks or even months before they can lay their eyes on their new beautiful ride. But there is an upside. There's the joy of knowing knowing that somebody put their heart and soul into every piece of your ride. He was probably underpaid and doesn't have health insurance, but that's a different story. Supercars, from concept to completion, typically have love and attention poured into every detail, and are usually tested thoroughly by a race car driver before you even get your hands on it. Supercar companies have reputations to uphold, and any tiny problem on a car that cost upwards of $500,000 would be kind of a disaster. Now, that's not to say there's never a problem on a supercar. In fact, it's kind of the opposite. There's always a problem on a supercar. One of the defining qualities of a supercar is its scarcity. By design, most supercars made today are extremely rare. And it's not just because they're unique and hard to make. That scarcity actually serves a purpose. Why is gold and silver more expensive than copper? I'm not gonna dive into an economics lesson for you. You should have learned that in school, unless you're American. You didn't learn anything in school. But essentially, those metals are rarer and harder to find, and thus more valuable. It's called supply and demand. Scarcity of a commodity can drive up the price of absolutely anything. And companies that produce supercars probably understand this better than most anyone. So when Aston Martin makes the 2020 Valkyrie, they know that if they only make 150 of them, they instantly become collector's items, enabling them to charge more per car. Sure, they can make more of them, but then everyone would have one, and who would care? I would care. I would like an Aston Martin Valkyrie. Please make more of them so that they're cheap enough for me to afford. Please. Build more cars, get more money. Seems like a pretty sound business strategy to me. Essentially, supercar makers are lazy. They don't want to build so many cars, so they just charge more for less of them. And it doesn't just stop there. Sometimes supercar manufacturers will build even rarer versions of their already rare cars and charge even rarer money for it. So very often, the people buying supercars aren't buying them even to drive them. They're just collectors, vying for bragging rights to have the most unique car in the parking lot or in their garage. And having the rarest car on the road is a pretty pride-driven endeavor. So the rarer the car, the more people are willing to pay for it. And the last factor that contributes to the insane prices of supercars is a strategy employed by basically every industry in the world. It's called marketing, you idiot. Who doesn't know about f***ing marketing? And sure, the newest Ferrari that's $400,000 definitely has some advantages over your $20,000 Toyota. Why do I keep riffing on Toyota? Let's go with Ford. You Mustang owners. But a big reason that they can charge so much for that Ferrari is not because of the performance. It's not really proportional. It mostly comes down to branding, marketing, and social clout. Oftentimes, when you're buying a supercar, a big part of that insane price tag is that shiny badge on the hood. This pretty much goes back to the fact that people buy supercars because they want to give off an outward appearance of wealth. You're not going to get the respect and attention that you want, you narcissist, if you're driving a hyper-fast Kia. Nissan GTR, anyone? It's as fast as a Ferrari. Why doesn't it cost as much as a Ferrari? Because it has the same Nissan emblem on it that the dude in the slow lane driving the minivan has. It doesn't matter how fast or beautiful that car is. People are gonna assume it didn't cost very much. Companies like Aston Martin, Rolls-Royce, Bugatti, Ferrari spend tons of money on marketing to associate their brands with that high luxury, high roller lifestyle. They all go out of their way to maintain that exclusive, luxurious brand image. To make sure that you know when I say the word Ferrari, I'm talking about something special. And it's why you pretty much never hear your favorite rapper rapping about their town and country. This...
I woke up in a new Toyota. Yeah. I woke up in a new Toyota. Yeah.
Just doesn't have the same ring to it as...
I woke up in a new Bugatti. I woke up in a new Bugatti.
So there's your answer. That's why you can't afford a new Ferrari. Why don't you let us know in the comments what your favorite supercar is? And while you're down there, hit the like button and the subscribe button and the other buttons. What other buttons are there? Are there other buttons? And after that, check out some more ideal content. And while you're doing that, make sure that you keep living the ideal lifestyle.